Hello, this is the Survey of Kenya. In today's tutorial, I'll be showing you how to orient your total station when you have two known points. In my case, I have two known points and a checkpoint. I will orient with one and then I'll check with the other. So what do we need for this job? We need a total station, a tripod, a prism and a prism stand, a book, a calculator and a pen. Let's get right into it. For this job, we have the coordinates of three points. Traverse point number one, which is this one here. This is our traverse point number one. This is our traverse point number two. And this is our traverse point number three. To start off the job, we will set up our total station at traverse point 1. In case you might be having a challenge setting up a total station or you'd want to refresh on some details on the same, there is this link provided above here. Our channel has the video on how to set up a total station. You can always check it out. And there we have it. Our total station is set. These are the coordinates that I have. Traverse point 1, where we have set our machine. Traverse point 2, where we are going to orient our machine. And traverse point 3, that we are going to use to check that our orientation is correct. So we need to find the distance and bearing of traverse point 1 to traverse point 2. And the bearing and distance of traverse point 1 to traverse point 3. To get the bearing and distance, we need to compute the change in northings and changes of eastings between traverse 1 and traverse 2. How do we do that? To get the change in northings, we subtract the northing of traverse 2 as shown, subtracted by the northing of traverse 1. That is equal to negative 7.53. And then now we will compute the change in eastings, which is gotten by the easting of traverse 2 subtracted by the easting of traverse 1, which is equal to 14.54. Now we have the change in northings and the change of eastings. To get the distance and bearing, we do a pole, change in northings and a pole change in eastings equal to, we get the distance as 16R is equals to 16.37, and then the bearing is equal to 117 degrees 22 minutes and 43.72 seconds, which is equal to 44 seconds. We'll circle that. Now we will get the change in northings and the change of eastings of traverse 1 to traverse 3. So to get that, traverse 3 northing subtracted by the northing of traverse 1, which is equal to negative 24.57. Then we'll compute the change in eastings, which will be equal to the easting of traverse 3 subtracted by the easting of traverse 1 as shown in the calculator. We get that to be -5.58. And then we will compute now the distance and bearing, pole change in northings, comma change in eastings, and we will get our answer as R to be 25.195 to two decimal places, that 25.20, and the bearing plus 360 equal to 192.47. We'll circle that. We have computed the distance and bearing of traverse point 1 to traverse point 2, our orientation, and traverse point 1 to traverse point 3, and these are the figures. So let's go back to our total station. Keeping in mind that our total station is set at traverse point 1, we will now have to input the bearing of traverse point 1 to traverse point 2 so that we can orient. This is how you do it. You escape. So once you escape, we are looking for how we are going to set the horizontal angle. In my total station, this is the setting, F3, HA set. So I'll click on F3, and then I will input the bearing of traverse point 1 to traverse point 2, which is 117. When you are inputting degrees and minutes, you just put the decimal and then the degrees and minutes follow each other. This is 22.44. That's the bearing of traverse 1 to traverse 2. Okay. Now I'll hold the bearing, meaning that even if I rotate my machine, as long as I have not clicked OK, this bearing will not change. So let's target the prism. We will unpack our prism and move to traverse point number 2. I'll now rotate my machine and target the prism with the lens. Level. Once I am certain that I have seen the prism and the prism is level, I'll click OK to orient. OK. There we have it. Our machine now has been oriented to 117, 22, 45. I'll measure the distance to confirm that it checks with the distance that I had computed. I'll go to menu, then data collect. I'll open a new job and I'll call it TUT1, I'll call it TUT1, okay. And then now, okay. And then I'll data collect. And then I will now measure. Measure. And I'll save this as point number 1. And I'll save it as TRV1. I'll save it as TRV2. This is TRV2. Save. The distance is 16.379. The computed distance was 16.38. Now we will move our machine and check whether traverse 3 is correct or it reads the same as the distance we had computed on datum. So I'll just rotate my machine and move it to traverse 3. I will target my prism. Once I target the prism and I'm satisfied that it is level, now I will click measure. So I'll measure the second time and a third time. Now the bearing reads 192, 47, 46, 45, 46 and a distance of 25.195. The computed distance was 25.20, an error of 5 millimeters. That is allowable error when using a total station. Now our machine has successfully been oriented and we have checked with an engraving point and it reads correctly. You can now begin your job successfully knowing that your machine reads the absolute bearing of this area. Thank you for watching this tutorial and see you in the next one.